Well, hello everyone. I'm Sam, one of your college and school liaison officers here at Blackpool and the Fylde College. And I'm here today with Andy Walker. He's one of our curriculum managers down at Blackpool School of Arts. Blackpool School of Arts is a part of Blackpool and the Fylde College. In reality, it's a self-contained arts school. It's located at University Centre, which is one of the Blackpool and the Fylde College campuses. That's located on Park Road in Blackpool. So a stone's throw really from the centre, the heart of Blackpool. You can see the tower from the campus. So if you're not familiar with where it's located, that's where you can find it. And here at Blackpool School of Art, there are many courses that would be considered under sort of broader term, the arts. So there are visual arts, performing arts, music, media. And you can progress, you can start off on level 2 courses if you're a school leaver, and you can stay at Blackpool School of Art should you wish all the way through into higher education and have your degrees awarded by Lancaster University, which is our degree affiliate, and it is a top 10 university here in the UK. So thank you ever so much, Andy, for taking the time to speak
You're welcome, Sam. Today.
I think what we want to get out of this really is to help prospective students that may be thinking about their future careers on leaving school and sort of putting to bed maybe some misconceptions about Blackpool School of Arts, about the type of courses that we have, and give them a better understanding. So I mentioned there about this being an arts school in effect as part of Blackpool and the Fylde College. I mentioned a few of the courses that we do, but would you mind sort of going into a bit of detail on the specific courses and the routes to those courses should school leavers be interested?
Absolutely. So we are an arts college, as you said. We're an arts institution, and we look at a wide range of different arts. So we go from the graphic design, we have fashion, we have performing arts, we have media, we have music, we have photography, we have your art. I'm sure I forgot one along the way there, but we have a wide range of different arts. We cover just about everything. So any type of art that you can think of, we will do here. And when you come to join us, we start very basics and we build up on every single level. So there is no high level as such when you start. You'll start the very basics and then build up towards a high level. So you talked about the students coming out to further education. That's where you'll start to do your learning. And hopefully you'll develop and get better and fall more in love with the subject you've picked and then progress on to one of our higher education courses. All the courses we have a representative higher education course which you can then progress on to afterwards.
Sure. And with those courses here at the School of Art, you yourself, you're one of the curriculum managers, but you're also a tutor, mm-hmm. and you have a specialty, as the other tutors do. That's really a key component, isn't it, about the sort of teaching element of not only Blackpool and Fylde College, but Blackpool School of Art?
Absolutely, absolutely. One of our biggest selling points is that every single one of your tutors is in that industry. We are not just teachers. We are professionals in our field and we are renowned in our field. So my specialism is darkroom, but also wildlife photography. So they're my two big specialisms. And every single one of your tutors will have their own little niche that they're involved in, but also have a really good understanding of the fundamentals of that area that you're going into. There won't be many other institutions within the country that have so many highly skilled professionals in their field with inside of an FE institution, and that's unique. You know, we are a provider of HE and FE, and along with that you get to get taught by some of the greatest HE tutors that I've ever encountered in the arts world, and they're teaching you at FE straight from school. You're getting an absolutely amazing experience with such high quality tutors.
And I think as well what you're saying there, obviously with the tutor level, that separation from maybe school, especially for our school leavers who maybe, let's say for example, they've been at school for a while and they're sort of, they're coming to the natural end of that part of their lives, that education, and they want to progress and maybe they want to be taken seriously in their craft and their trade. That's what's very different here, isn't it, at Blackpool School of Art? You're treated as an individual, you're treated sort of in the sort of adult world, let's say art sphere, straight away you're given employability skills, you're given a progress tutor, someone that's going to help you and nurture your talent all the way through. And that is backed by the industry tutors, the people like yourself who have had those real life experiences and then are passing that on to the new generation.
Absolutely, absolutely. You're entering into a professional standard environment. We are professionals and we expect professionalism from you. And that looks a lot different from when you're at school. We pride ourselves on the one aspect of respect. So we, you know, we ultimately respect you as an individual, and we respect you so much that we allow you to develop your style in whichever way it is, and that we expect you to respect us. That it's a two-way relationship, and we find that we are, a lot of students come to us and say, you are so different from school. You allow me to develop in my way and the way and a pace that suits me. And that's where we do differ. You know, we don't teach by the workbook. You don't open the workbook and go from page one to page 100. The journey is eclectic. It's all over the place. But it's because that's the way that your work might go. And because you've got such experienced professional tutors that you can bring them just about anything. And if we don't know it, we'll learn very fast to make sure we do know it so that you can get the very best experience and learn what you need to know very quick.
Yeah. I mean, I'm not just saying this, of course, because I'm part of the college as well. But every time I've been exposed to Blackpool School of Arts, what shines through, and you yourself, you're the sort of epitome of this, is the passion mm-hmm. that everyone here has. Not the tutors, but the students that I've come across as well. They're very passionate about their craft. Everyone works together. You know, it's this artistic hub, this artistic community here. And that, again, is very different to maybe a school environment. Schools are very supportive, of course they are. And they help progress students up to where they need to go on to the next stage of their lives. But here you're really taken care of and nurtured. There's a lot of cross-collaboration within college. Everyone is supporting everyone, looking after everyone. I think that's a key selling point.
And I 100% agree. I 100% agree. No matter how much you enjoyed school, there will be a subject or maybe a session that you didn't enjoy as much as the other one. Whereas here, if you pick one of our crafts, one of our areas, you're focusing on that. That is your passion. That is what you are striving and want to be. So you're going to be more invested in it. You're going to love it more. And yeah, the staff are passionate about it because that's their industry. You know, if we can't say really nice things about what we do and push across really passionately about what we're teaching, then we're selling ourselves short by not loving our subject. And we all love our subject so much that we live and breathe it. You know, I put my pen down, my laptop down on a Friday at 5:30 and I go home. But then I pick my camera up and I start doing commercial work 6:30 on a Friday night and I start straight away. I love the fact that I can still develop myself as a professional outside of here, but much more than that, I love instilling knowledge on students, and that's my ultimate passion, is getting you, the guys who join us, to become passionate and love the subject that I love as well.
I think what's so nice about hearing you say things like that is that, you know, there might be an element in life as well where some people and students are thinking, you know, oh, I'm going to go traditional routes into the workplace. Things have to be 9 to 5. I think with the arts community, you say you have a working week and you do everything at college, but you then have that ambition and drive and desire to continue on taking your photography with you after work. And I think that really would, to a young person who's wanting a craft, whether that be in visual arts here, whether they're interested in the performing arts, if that's dance or musical theatre, that they live and breathe that passion. And you guys here, the tutors and the technicians, everyone that provides that support at Blackpool School of Arts, pushes and drives the students to really live that experience throughout their time with us.
Yeah, and I would be, again, selling my students short if I wasn't being a professional in that industry. You know, with being a professional in that industry, it keeps my finger on the pulse of what's happening in the real world, and I can then bring those live experiences back to the classroom, and that's what's ultimately important. There is no point me teaching people when I haven't been in the industry for 10 years. What happened 10 years ago in the photography industry is vastly improved and vastly moved on since then. And performing arts and graphics and music, the change is fast. So without being able to be commercially involved in that industry, you'll fall behind. And that's where the experience the students get when they come to us here is they're getting people who are going into the real world and who are involved in the real world. And like I say, and I say it all the time, we don't just teach to the criteria. Of course we want you to pass, and of course we want you to do well and achieve the very best grades in every single thing you do. We teach you how to be professionals, and we teach you how to be creative. One of the biggest selling skills in industry at the moment is a creative mind. If you look at any sort of job specification out there, they're all asking for creative approaches because creativity is one of the most valuable skills that happens within the workplace. And that's what makes small companies into big companies. That's what makes big companies into huge companies. The chance and the ability to be creative and better than your competitors. And I think that's one of the biggest skills that our students live with, a mindset where they can look at the world, think about it creatively, add that creative learning to it, and make it better.
So I think, taking on from that point you've sort of raised there, a lot of the students that will come here then get quite a broad range of transferable skills. Obviously, I would assume a lot of people, when they come here, want to go into a creative industry in the future. They may develop that over time because of the fact that we do a lot of cross-collaboration here. So you may be doing a visual arts course, but you might take inspiration from people doing performing arts. You may work together to create projects. People may think that there are very traditional routes into employment. You know, if you do performing arts, you're going to be an actor or an actress. If you do visual arts, you're going to be a photographer. But are there, because of what you've said there, being a creative and having that creative mindset opens doors to you? Are there any sort of intriguing industry, something outside of the box that people may not, especially younger prospective students, may not be aware of that it could lead to if they came here on a creative course?
Well, it's funny you say that, because we had a live experience of this just a couple of days ago, where a student came to me, and the whole time he was with us at the institution, he had a part-time job working for the biggest, I'd say, computer shop in the country, many chains everywhere. And he worked on the shop floor with them selling computers, day in, day out of an evening. He then did his degree with us, and then he went on to be management within that department store that he worked in. He then did his degree in photography. He's now produces their advertisements for them. So he's now their creative director on advertisements for them. Yeah. So he started off with a job just selling computers, but because he could apply the skills and knowledge and the creativity, he could then apply that, and he progressed into a creative route in a very non-traditional creative way. And there are a lot of employers out there that employ our students with our skills. They may employ our students to be gallery technicians, but then they develop and they build to be gallery directors, creative gallery directors. There's a student of ours who, all the time he was with us on the media course, he did the media course for 3 years with us. And all that time he was working in cinema, just selling tickets. He then went to be a manager at an art house cinema in Manchester. And now he's creating commercial and advertising material for all of the art house cinemas of that brand across the country. So it's about where you start and how you apply your creative knowledge that you've learnt with us that might take you on these weird and wonderful journeys that might send you on a completely different route.
Well, I think that's, you know, that's a lovely set of examples that just demonstrate what you're going to get out of your time if you're a prospective student thinking about doing an arts course here at Blackpool School of Arts, that it doesn't have to be a traditional route. No. You don't have to pick up a camera and become a photographer. You might go on a different pathway, but you're going to get those skills here. In terms of, to sum up, if you were going to give a piece of advice to prospective students out there that may be looking in the future ahead to what they might like to do, they're a bit of a creative, they're not too sure necessarily what route they want to go down, but they want, you know, they've dipped their toes into it, what would you say to them? What to look out for? What can Blackpool School of Art provide them to help nurture them in their future ambitions?
So I can only use my personal experience as an example, and I do tell this story to all my students. I went down the very traditional route of doing my GCSEs, and then I went on to do A-levels, and I didn't really achieve at my GCSEs for many reasons, and then I didn't really achieve at my A-levels for many reasons. I then walked into an arts campus, and I fell in love. And that was, I think, the first time I actually started to learn and actually started to develop as a person and as an artist. And I think if you do have an interest in art and you really want that, once that is your life and that's what you're about, go for it. Absolutely go for it. Don't try and dip your toes in it. Just immerse yourself in it and get involved in that world. And I can guarantee you, you won't be disappointed. If your passion is at painting, do painting. If your passion is photography, do photography. If your passion is performance, be a performing artist. Go and do it. Because if you are passionate about it, you will achieve amazing things.
That's so nice to hear, Andy. You know, we really appreciate the time given to talk about the School of Art, you know, in this forum, just to give that insight to prospective students who, you know, over the course of the next few years might be thinking of what routes to take, and that the Blackpool School of Art's doors are open to people that want to take their artistic and creative minds onto the next level. So thank you so much for that.
No, thank you.
And for anyone who is interested in learning a bit more about what there is on offer at Blackpool School of Arts, you can find all the information on the different courses that we offer on our website, www.blackpool.ac.uk. You can check out all of the course information. If you're interested in applying, if that might be the stage that you're at in your school education, then you can click on the apply button and it will take you through to our online applications. Do check out our website as well for all the information on student support. You can check out information on any of our open events that we have coming up. Obviously, then get a bit more of an overview of our different offer. We do have a lot of social media channels as well, so you can follow us on those. I think from the School of Arts perspective, you're on Instagram, you're on Twitter,
YouTube.
You've got YouTube, you've got everything. We're very, very modern, obviously. We've got lots of different options on social media. You can engage with people who obviously alumni of the college, people who are active at the college, obviously interact with those and get as much information as you would like. But again, once again, Andy, thank you so much for your time today. And we do look forward to seeing some of you, hopefully, here at Blackpool School of Art in the future.